Ending poverty seemed impossible a generation ago, but recent events will bring to light that this is not the case. This idea was officially announced in the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals as something that would be achieved by 2030. A poor neighborhood is not just an area where poor people live. It is an area that is poor in resources like good schools, quality childcare, and safe recreation. Children need these resources in order to thrive. On average, growing up in an area of concentrated poverty means poorer health, lower school achievement, and worse adult outcomes. Children who live in high poverty neighborhoods are more likely than other children to witness domestic violence. The fear, stress, and self-blame that often accompany exposure to family violence are traumatic for children and can have long-term consequences. Entrepreneurship, especially social entrepreneurship, brings value to the fight against poverty that other players, governments, corporations, and non-governmental organizations don't. Entrepreneurs solve problems. Social entrepreneurs solve problems that matter. Eradicating poverty pegs the mattering meter. Effective social entrepreneurs relieve burdens by selling products that customers need to improve their lives. In addition, entrepreneurship introduces a new way of thinking, which could be effective in the hands of children having to endure poverty and the effects of poverty. With this in mind, I've taken the initiative of volunteering at a local primary school in the community of Bontheville, a poverty-stricken community in Cape Town subjected to drug abuse, crime, and violence, where I taught young kids in grades 4 to 7 how to think and act like an entrepreneur over the course of 2 weeks. The first half of the program encouraged learners to think creatively, combat setbacks, and be more curious in their pursuit to solve problems.
So an entrepreneur is someone that takes a risk to start a business that provides a need or a want. So when you're starting a business as an entrepreneur, it's not just one way to do something. And did he give up when he got hurt the first time?
No.
Did he give up when he got hurt the second time?
No.
Did he give up when he got hurt the third time?
No.
So just like that, when you're an entrepreneur, you can't give up.
Have you?
No.
We need to be
creative.
The second half of the program focused primarily on goal setting and planning with the help of WHOOP, a science-based mental strategy that people can use to find and fulfill their wishes, set preferences, and change their habits.
Then it's outcome. What's going to happen if you get what you want? Then it's a obstacle. Say it together.
Obstacle.
And that is what stands in our
way.
And then the last thing is our plan. How are we going to overcome the obstacle? So it's first,
at the end of the program, learners had a better sense of direction and were able to identify problems in their community they could solve through entrepreneurial thinking. They also felt more comfortable setting goals and had more confidence in their capabilities.
An entrepreneur is someone that takes risks.
What is an entrepreneur?
Entrepreneur is had to be creative and create jobs for business, and entrepreneur never give up.
Then what can we use when things go wrong?
Stop.
What does stop stand for?
Stop, think, and options and plan.
What did you do with the page?
We had to fold it up with our eyes closed and we had to peel off the corners. And then when we unfolded it, then we saw that we didn't get the same shapes and sizes.
And what did that teach you about being an entrepreneur?
You need to be creative and it's good to be different.
And if you want something, what do you do?
You whoop.
Whoop. Now what does whoop stand for?
You wish, then your outcome will come, and then your obstacle will be there, and then you must plan.
Plan. If you had to start a business, what business would you start?
A sports business.
Sports business.
We should encourage creative thinking and curiosity in young people and equip them with the skills to combat setbacks. If we can build a strong foundation for young people to pursue a life in entrepreneurship or even engage in entrepreneurial thinking, we'll be building a generation that will bring an end to poverty.